Yo, what's up, fam? How's everybody doing today, man? I'm doing fantastic. So check it out, right? A few years ago, I was sitting down with some friends of mine when we were having a discussion about death. And they were saying, nah, are you afraid of dying? And I remember my answer vividly. I said, yes, I am very much afraid of dying. But why would you be afraid of dying? Because it's inevitable. You can't control it. You're going to die anyway. And I figured, yes, they're absolutely right. That is a fact. I'm going to die anyway. So therefore, I shouldn't be afraid. Right? But I came home after that and I thought about it a little bit. And now thinking about it again today, I think to myself, why can I get chabaroha at that time? Why was I afraid of death? Why is it that I was afraid that I could no longer exist? What is this fear that I have about death? So I just thought to myself, the number one reason why we are afraid of dying is because deep down we know we have not actually lived. Yes, we have been alive. Yes, but deep down we feel, there are some things that we have not yet done. There is a way of being that we have not yet been. There are things with our lives that we wanted to do or still want to do. There are ambitions. There's a way that we want to come across into the universe, into the world that we have not yet reached. And we are aware. When they look at us, catching the dira, when they look at you, catching the bupela, when they want to buy longer, maybe get your go batusha, and ask you to go no batusha. When they look at you longer, ask you to go no the dira mo pelo juaga. And because of that, if in kahwa right now, I'm aware of the fact that I would have not lived a full life. I would have denied myself of a full life, or life would have denied me of an experience of a lifetime. I know, Rory, if I had more time, if I really did the time, the things that I wanted to do, if I got the computer, I can produce that life, I can live that work, and then I can finally be happy with myself when I die. Because when I look back and I look at all the things relaying and all the people that I've touched and the lives that I have impacted, think about all of that happening, then I would be happy with myself dying. But many of us don't feel that way, because deep down we know how we have not yet lived. So let me ask you a question. Are you afraid of dying? Is it because maybe you feel that you have not yet lived the life that you truly, truly want to live? Is it because that you know that you can do better than you have done, that you can express yourself more and better and a higher and better expression of yourself? You know that you can be a bigger, bolder, braver person, and you can have the things. You know you have not been yourself. So you're afraid that if you die now, this representation of yourself, this current person only nyena, has not yet actually represented you the way no nyaka to represent akawana mole fasting. And as a result, you find yourself in a situation where you are aware that if you died now, you would have died an unlived life. So I just want to challenge you. If you are aware, Jorge, you're afraid of dying. If your answer to my question is yes, Molo, yes, yes, I'm afraid of dying, then here's what I say to you. It's time for you to find out what you are living for, or what you are dying to do. King say longo roka fetogo sidira o ka thabela ge lehule ka tla ke bo phele ba muhuta manje longo roka bo phela o ka sebele bothata ge lehule ka tla. Who do you wanna be before death comes? How do you want your life to be before death comes? Whose lives do you wanna touch? Huh? Who do you want to inspire? How do you want to live? What are your dreams? What are your goals? What kind of car? What kind of house? What kind of things do you want to do with yourself before death comes? Because death is coming. Death is coming. So I said to myself, Ntuneng, it is fundamentally wrong for you to be afraid to die. Find out what you are living for. And once I found my purpose, once I found the thing that I am here to do, because I do believe that we are here for a purpose, and that's largely the reason why we feel like we are not yet fulfilled, that we cannot say like, Paul, my mission is done, I can go. Most of us don't feel that way because we have not yet ventured into our mission yet. We have not tapped into our mission yet. So I say discover it, because that is where your fulfillment is going to come from. And even if you never reach the million and you never, but when you look at your life and you look at how you express yourself and you look at how you went for that thing that you wanted and you went for it and you drove yourself and you disciplined yourself and you read the books and you changed yourself and you pursued the thing. And then finally, when you're 40, 60, 80, 90, and you look back, and even if you never have millions and you never have a mansion and you never have a life that others would consider amazing, but when you look at your own experience, when you look at how things have turned out for you, you can say, man, I live. I can be happy to go. I'm happy to go now. I've touched the lives of the people that I wanted to touch. I have done the things I wanted to do. I traveled. I read books. I experienced my true self. I went out there. I threw myself. I did things. And I lived life to the fullest. And now, even if death comes, even if I'm 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, guess what? I have lived a rich life, and therefore I will not be afraid of death, because I know that I'm not cheating myself. Because the only reason we are afraid of dying is because we know deep down we are cheating ourselves of a true life that we have not yet lived. But once you get into your life and you get into your purpose and you ask yourself questions like, who am I? Why am I here? And what am I here to do? And you start living into that, what we call the purpose-driven life, where every step is systematic, it is planned, it is the intentional life, right? Then you can look at your life and say, wow, I have lived. And even if death comes now, I'm happy to go, because I've been myself. So don't be afraid to die. The only reason you're afraid is because you have not yet found yourself in your true purpose, and the reason why only Tlemol fasting. So once you find that purpose and you start doing a little bit of it, you don't have to worry about a lot of things. It's just about knowing how your life is fulfilling to you every single day when you wake up. And when you finish a week, a month, or a year, you can look back and say, wow, I might not have gotten everything I wanted, but I lived this year. This year was one of the most amazing years for my life this year. And you can say, you know what? I'm happy with myself. And even if death comes, I know that I lived. I know that I took this opportunity that's called life, and I embraced it, and I fell in love with it, and I didn't cheat myself, and I felt good about who I am and what I'm doing with myself. And as a result, once the one who gave me this life comes to get it, I'll be happy, because I'm grateful that I got this chance to live. And I wish that for you and for your children and your family, because we're here to experience who we truly are, the best and great expression of ourselves. We're not here to accumulate, we're here to be. So be the best you. Be who you who are born to be. Don't be afraid of the things outside. It's all about how you feel about yourself inside of you. Don't be afraid of death. Be afraid of not living a life that you want, the life that fulfills you. That is the most scariest part. Because when death comes, you can't change that. And that's where the regret comes from. But if you decide to live an intentional life and you go into your purpose and you say, I'm going to find myself, even when death comes and you still have not achieved the things, you know that everybody dies and we all die at different times. But at least you know what? When you had this thing, you sucked the marrow out of it. You lived, man. You were not afraid. You went after yourself, after your heart, and you chased after it. And it felt so good to be you. And then when you finally die, hallelujah. Cheers, fam. I'll catch you on the next video.